The Indian Space Research Organization ISRO to launch an electronic intelligence satellite named EMISAT for Defense Research and Development Organization DRDO in the coming month. ISRO, in this special mission, will also be launching 28 third-party satellites and demonstrate its new technologies like three different orbits with a new variant of Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle, PSLV, rocket. ISRO will be trying to orbit the rocket at three different altitudes using a PSLV rocket with four strap on motors. The main components of the rocket will be the EMISAT, which weighs about 420 kg. Other 28 satellites weigh about 250 kg. Exercise Sampriti 2019, which is a joint military exercise involving India and Bangladesh, is set to start from 2nd March to 15th March 2019 at Tangail, Bangladesh. Both the countries have been alternatively hosting the exercise. This will be the 8th edition. Exercise Sampriti is a significant bilateral endeavor between India and Bangladesh, resulted from ongoing India-Bangladesh defense cooperation. This is an exercise to build, strengthen and promote positive relations between the two armies of the countries. The exercise will lay ground for both the army to understand tactical level operations of each others. Indian Oil Corporation Limited IOCL and the Inland Waterways Authority of India IWAI signed a Memorandum of Understanding on 26th February 2019 for conjointly developing infrastructure for natural gas, lubricating oil, LPG and oil, etc. for meeting the requirement of national waterways. The MOU covers expansion of infrastructure for receipt, storage, dispensing and supply of natural gas, lubricating oil, LPG and oil for domestic and commercial use, petroleum and any other related fuel and gas. The pact is expected to lead to expansion of business accomplishments along the national waterways. On 26th February 2019, Assam Chief Minister Sarbananda Sonowal launched the Pranam Commission, which is panel systematized to care for the issues regarding a bill brought in for the protection of parents of state government employees. The Parents' Responsibility and Norms for Accountability and Monitoring Bill, quantified to be the first of its kind bill in the nation, targeted to protect aging parents of government employees in their times of need. The Pranam Bill makes it obligatory for the state government employees to care for their unmarried, differently abled siblings who do not have their own sources of income and elderly parents. The bill would benefit 8 lakh parents of 4 lakh state government employees.